Guys, welcome to episode 2 of Card the Tasmanian Tiger. I'm recording this straight afterwards. I got back to the end of the level and teleported back, and he was biting on nothing. In this episode, if I just go through a brief description, we'll be going for more cogs because we want the new boomerang at the end of this level. We also get new boomerangs in the level that we're going to be doing, but you will see what they are shortly. The game's already 10% complete, which, again, there's 9 levels, so every level is 10%, then the final boss level. But I think there's a few levels in between the 9 levels that we do. Back. Yes. We 100% completed this one. I know that says 400 out of 300, but we did it, if you remember correctly. These we didn't find. I'm not even sure about these myself, as I never got these on my last, when I played this years ago. We'll see how many opals we need to unlock the next. Stop lagging. I can stop lagging, thank you. We need 9 more. 9. So if even if we complete one level, we'll unlock the next set of levels, I believe. But this one's going to be Shipwrecks. That one over there is one of my favourites. I say one of my favourites, I have a few. In fact, now I'm going to come out, I'm going to say that is my favourite level. The one over there. But we're going to save that for next episode, and we're going to go with Shipwrecks. I do like this one, this is a fun one. So, we're going to get straight into it. Quickly come get these opals and do a few of these. So this one is really, really nice. I loved the layout of this one. So we're gonna, I'm hoping these are taking screenshots. If not, I'll have to get them separately, but yeah, that's what I was hoping for. Yeah, it's on a beach with Rex, the guy sat on top of that. He's the lifeguard, but he's an ocean lifeguard, if that makes sense, or a sea lifeguard. Yeah. This episode might be slightly longer. Actually, no, I think it will be about the same size. We don't have to explain as much because you'll have understood what the actual aim of the game is and what we're actually doing, but only if you've watched the first episode. But the episodes get, the levels get progressively harder. Depending on which sort of level we're on. As you can see down there, there are a set of boomerangs that we can't get yet for some unbeknownst reason. Any more stuff? No. I think a fly's just bit my finger. Because it hurt. There we are. Dangerous bollock. Basically, his wife is on an island and he wants me to go and find them. Come on. Right, this is when we have to go back and get the aqua ring. I did that a lot quicker than I thought I would, to be fair. I sort of expected to not land on them straight away and have to swim a little bit. But as you can see, the reason I didn't like this level as much is because it was quite difficult to do some of the challenges or to do some of the quests involved. But we're just going to run through. Opals, I found, were the hardest thing because there's so many islands, you don't know which ones you've been on and which ones you haven't. And it's not as straightforward as you'd think. This is when we start seeing the more challenging aspects of the game come into it and what made the game so fun. And take quite a while because that first tutorial level was obviously a lot easier than these are. Now we yeah, we might as well go and quickly do this. While we're over here. That's two. Done already on this level, out of 10. But yeah, see, I'm already a bit disorientated. The arrows do help. Them ones there. Get him, get him. But they only send you in the direction to the end of the map, sort of thing. Hello? Not specifically where the opals will be, if that makes sense. So the arrows direct you to sort of where you need to go. Obviously some of the opals will be in them boxes. I'm not actually going to go get them yet, but I'm going to refer back to that bit. What do you want? Ooh. Oh god, I hate these. So you go like this. Sorry. Hey! I was useless at doing this bit, like previously. I don't think I'm doing too bad. Obviously, you can stay in there as long as you want and they stop you from getting eaten by the sharks. But I think the end of this level is quite quick to get to, whereas the actual challenges are so far apart, obviously. From there to there, it's not the longest journey. But from there to there to there to there, and quite a lot of them are spread out. Oh god, you can't reach. Wait. Obviously, again, I know from past experience what I'm doing. But, yeah. Get him, get him, get him, get him. See, we're almost halfway through the opals already, but once we get to sort of around 200, that's when it starts getting a bit more challenging. So, now that's something I didn't like that they added to the game. The camera automatically turns, and I'm moving my mouse right now, but it won't change the direction of the way I'm looking, and I'm not entirely sure why. It sort of tries to focus around getting to the centre of the thing. I was never too sure on why they did that. I don't believe it was in the original version of Ty, but again, don't quote me on that. Back to normal, thank you. I've reached his wife. What a lovely looking lady. Rex is worried a bit. I remember she was always quite flirty. Yes, please. So let's actually have a look at the objectives. So again, collect 300 opals and find 5 bilbies. These are difficult as well, because like I said, these are spread out all over the map. Race Rex is the time trial. Where's Ellie? That's the first one we've done. Aurora's kids, we have to find a seahorse's kids. Quicksand coconuts, that one is infuriating. Shipwreck, again, I think that was the only one I never completed on PlayStation. I mean, I completed the game, but you didn't have to collect all of these, but we will do that for this series. And Nest Egg. I don't know what that one is. Not off the top of my head, anyway. Yeah. So, we will... Obviously, we can go straight back to the start from here, which is... I do apologise for that. I sneezed and I had to mute the mic. Whether it actually muted or not, I'll have to have a look. But my god, that was the loudest sneeze I've ever done. Hey, one more of them done. Can you jump straight off this? Yeah, that's where we hand the opals in. Oh. Down there. There's a bilby there, I'm not entirely sure how you get to it. I never noticed that. Oh, you can see them. So there's one there. Or there. There's one over there, I'm not sure how well you can make it out. One over there by the looks of it. Wow. The shipwrecks is there. So. Ooh. There's some stuff down there. Now, I'm not sure what that gives us. But I assume it's alright. We're going to try and float down here. See if there's any boxes. Now that's where we came onto the island. As you can see, it starts the trail up around the island. So we're going to head sort of this way. And see if there are any boxes that we can open. Just quickly run, have a lap around the island. I can see this being quite a long episode, you know. And I can see it being quite entertaining for me and you. Because I'm keeping it as... Oh! Hello! That was lucky I noticed. It seems to be keeping at 60 FPS quite well. Which I'm happy about. Doesn't seem to be lagging as much as it did in the last episode. So again, I'm in a bit of a better mood now. Compared to what I was earlier. I'm just hoping... I'm recording this straight after... I recorded the first episode, so expect to see no changes in my voice, audio levels, camera quality. What the fuck was that? Oh my god, that scared the shit jeebus out of me. Oh, I sort of instinctively clicked that button then. Hey, we've got one of those. Got a cog. Anyway. But yeah, so there'll be no change in anything immediately anyway. I might just do 3 episodes, edit them tonight and schedule them for the next 3 days. I think that's a good way to go. And I'm headed the wrong way. Right, so there's nothing around here. But as you can see, we've already... Oh, our oxygen levels are running low. Let's keep going quickly. Oh, that was a shark attack. Pardon me. And let's jump up here quickly to regain our oxygen levels. Let's go down here. Oh. 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 Is he in me? Oh. Right then. Sorry, mate. I'll avoid you next time. Up here. Yes. From the top of the mountain up there. God, can you believe that's where we've just come from? All the way up there. But yeah, we saw that it was a bilby down here, so I thought I'd investigate. It turns out that I could find where the bilby was. So we're going to go back and head, obviously, back this way. So that's sort of this area of the map scouted and looked at. I think it's quite good. Let's head this way. I can already see a cog. Brilliant. Let's go grab these boxes and the opals that come along with it. Da-da-da. Oh, bit of lag again. And that's just because of the amount of particles and entities on the screen. Right. Let me know whether you can see why this was one of my favourite games as a kid. It's got sort of that simplistic tone to it, yet was enjoyable by adults. I remember playing this at my auntie's house on her PlayStation and just chewing Hubba Bubba for days. And God, I love those memories. And for you Becky that know my family, I used to play this at Hayley's. When I'd stay around. Now those, I'm not sure whether I can actually break those. Oh, I can. Oh, sorry, I was a bit loud. Right, I can start collecting the pictures. I thought I had to have an infrared, an infrarang, sorry, I think is what they're called, is to see the boxes properly and break them. Oh, gone back. I had to do that through the lag. I do apologise if that looks awful. That's 3 out of 5 bilbies done already. I'm progressing quite quickly compared to... Oh, I can see one over there. Let's head that way and see whether I can complete it. I know that there's opals on there, which is another infuriating and slow process to get done. Oh, there's two holes. Oh, that's what I remember. Yeah. Right, so that isn't part of this bit. And there's the other quest. So that will be done in a few minutes. First, let's complete these areas. Now, let's do this one first. I know you have to jump in. Oh, no, 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 no. Get up, get up. Kill him, kill him. You have to stand on this and wait till it blows you in the air. As such. And then sort of... Oh. There we are. You sort of stay on this until you go all the way around. And then hop on those all the way along to get the cog. So while I'm waiting, I'm going to grab a drink, because I think you're just going the same sort of circle around them. But yeah. I almost completed the circle. I think I'll be on 210 by the time I've done this one, which means there's still 90 to collect. Gee willikers. Please set. Thank God, I thought these were one of the ones where you can't hook on. Because. Hey, there we are. Now. I'm actually going to go for that basket over there. On the basis that it could give me a bit more health. There we go. Oh, it gave me a whole health. Come on. Okay. Let's kill these frills. But if you can see, which is why this level was infuriating for me as a kid, because I didn't really grasp the sort of coordination side of things or what exactly to do, but this dark coloured sand is quicksand, so you go in it and you start to sink and flip a doodah. Oof, almost died. In fact, I think I might have just lost a bit of health, and so the only way to get out of it is to walk across. Oh, I've got another life. Yeah, it's to walk across towards the edges and try and hope that it lets you back up. If not, you die and you get respawned at the start. Which brings us on to this challenge over here, which is one of the ones that I struggled with a lot. We used to struggle with. mainly because of sort of the camera angles and how they used to be. Right, let's get the piece of pie. See, you can't jump when you're in the quicksand, so I think I've just died. Oh no, you can sort of crawl back out. I never knew that. Okay. I don't entirely know what I'm doing. Oh. Okay, so I've made it this part. That was almost infuriating. Let's see if I can. Wow. No, how does that not count? Thank you. Good God, this fine display of parkour skills. Come on, shoot it, thank you. No, it didn't jump. Oh, it did jump. Oh, that lag really threw me off a bit. Right, I've made it. Now's the part when we get back. Can you jump over here? Yes, you can jump over here. We already completed that bit. Of course we did. So overall, we've completed two so far. I thought we were doing a lot better than that, and we're already about 20 minutes in. Wow, longer episodes than I expected to be making. It started lagging a little bit again. Now it's, oh God, stop with the lag, please. Thank you. Again, I think it was just rendering in some graphics, because I'm on low graphics anyway. So this is the laggiest it's been all episode, but it shouldn't be too bad. Now this is why I never fully completed the game as a kid. Well, I did, but not 100%. It's because I didn't know about this area. Okay. I feel like these episodes are going to be me talking about what I did as a kid and what I remember from being a kid until we hit the later levels. The later levels, because I never did them. Oh, well, I can't remember this bit for a start, which is a good sign, I suppose, because it means we're on the right track. Hey, 4 out of 5. Ah, oh, there's another one of them up there. Yeah, I assumed that for them, I mean, I've seen them plenty of times. I thought you needed the infrared that you get sort of, oh, I don't know, later on in the game to properly view them and then obviously open them or break them sort of thing. But I didn't realise you could just have a look at them. Because that's what I thought the whole point of the infrared was, is so we could see them and see through things and, you know, get them. Ooh. This seems a bit too easy. Oh, I thought there'd be a catch. Anyway, let's head over that way and get the cog. And yes, I'm saying cog, COG, not COCK. Any cop Troll's coming. Troll me for saying the wrong thing. You little ripper. Right, so how many is that? Ooh. 279. We're not that far away, guys. Now, I remember how to do this-ish. I remember this being quite a predicament, I want to say. Because of how awkward it is. Basically, we need to unlock this latch by shooting at a button on the inside. However, it's so hard to get to the place where you need to see inside. Where is it? Down here. Right, I'm gonna go up for air so quickly and sort of reset my camera angles. Go! Wow, the camera flare. Look at the lens flare. Oh, sorry, I do apologise. Look at that lens flare. Right, let's try again, shall we? There's. Oh! Aha! There we are. Just needed a bit of a camera angle reset. There we are. So, how many is that completed? 4 out of 8. That's not too bad. Aurora's Kids is going to be okay. We just need to race Rex and collect the, such the basics. Other than Aurora's Kids. Which is easily enough, I believe. I think there's either 5 or 7 kids. It's when we get onto the middle levels that I struggled the most, because they were the levels where they took a bit longer, so I lost interest as a kid, if that made sense, and I never made it onto the further levels, if that makes any sort of sense. There's Aurora, but before we go to her, we're just gonna complete this one, because then we've completed the Bilbies. I'm correct in saying that, yeah. So, Aurora, let's go back to you. Right, so we have to help find her little kids. And I believe they're glowing pink also, yeah. So, 1 out of 8, okay. So basically, I'm just going to go swimming around the map until I find them all. Two. Oh, there's one. Three. You can tell they didn't have much of a budget for this film because the script and the way they speak. Oh, there.
Yippee.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Sounds like something out of Kevin and Perry. Let's keep going. I believe they're all sort of in a similar area. They're not like spread across the map that much, because look, we've already found 5 out of 8. Is there 1 or 2 around here? 1 down there. So we found 6 already. Now it's just finding the rest. We came from that way, and she was from that way, so let's try and find just around this corner. We've been around there, let's go down here. So this direction. We'll go this way and we'll loop back around. Aha, there's one. If yes, that is. So just one left. And I'm hoping she's around here. Well, there they are. There we are. That was easy enough. That was a lot easier than I thought it would be. Let's take them back. If I can find her. Over here, correct? Right, them lens flares are doing my head in. Well, the little things. Oh hey, how may I repay you? Well, love. No, I'm just kidding. A little rock would do me. So, game info. We've done all race wrecks and collect the opals. If we continue and go to wrecks, here's that way. To swim faster, you go underwater, but if you go underwater, you lose your breath. Racing wrecks was one of the most infuriating things as a kid, because again, like I said, with the camera angle and how it was on PlayStation, it made it so awkward and just so. Oh god. Yeah, it made it so awkward to run around, and as you can see, Rex is a lot quicker in the water, being a platypus and all. But I think we're a lot quicker on the land than he is. So not only do we have to do the time trial and make sure we go through these, which can be it can be really frustrating, especially when the camera angle is so wrong, you'd miss one and have to go back, and yeah, you get the gist of that. I've got a feeling Rex is right behind me. I think that's how the game used to work, was where if you were like so far ahead of him, he'd just catch up because you couldn't see him. Come on. I think he might overtake me in a second, unless we're really ahead of him. There we are, see? But then we just absolutely thrash him up here. But again, because of these camera angles up here, and the fact it auto locks, it can make it really difficult. Then there's two or three jumps that, you know, if you miss, you go right to the bottom of the mountain, and that can just be excruciatingly painful to watch and do. But I believe we've done it. There's no way he's catching me on foot. I'm tempted to carry on recording. This one was a pain, that little jump there, but no, we did it okay. I'm tempted to carry on recording tomorrow morning because it's getting quite late, and I sort of want to edit the first two and get them rendered. That'd be quite nice. Oh, oh, move the camera. Where did it? Hey. Yes, there we go. We didn't go through the portal, so we haven't set the things back here yet, which is a bit of a pain. So the last thing we really need to do, well, half an hour episode isn't that bad, but yeah, the last things we need to do is find the rest of the opals. Now they're gonna be on an island in boxes, because we've scoured quite a lot of the actual water area. So it's just a case of going around and making sure we've gone on everything. And making sure we... Oh, there's a few, look, see. Okay, we got them. Little backflip. Oh, we did all of that bit. Which way is it, that way? It's currently 10 past 12 at night. I'm quite wide awake, to be fair. And FIFA's still only on 50%. That is outrageously slow. I'm stuck on a shark. The reason I'm going this way is because I know we didn't go to the end. Actually, the bit where we hand in the opals, we didn't head there, and I think there's a fair few opals on that bit of land. Come on, underwater, come on. If you can't tell, to swim faster, we have to keep clicking space. Right, if we can undo these. These should be all here, correct? Hey, we did it! Is that everything? We're missing three of those, though. Might have to come back and do them at another time, because they're not as important at this stage. We're just trying to get through some of the levels. It might be something that we have to do at the end. So, sort of.
I don't know.
Get through all the levels, and where did the, did I get it? Yeah. So, get through all of the levels, get to the boss, but just before we do the boss fight, we go back through and try and collect all the collectibles as sort of like a bonus episode. I think that works quite well. I'm hoping I'm not shouting, because I've got my headphones off, and, no, I've got my headphones on, and obviously, you can't really hear much while you've got them on, other than the game. So the only thing you can really hear is your own voice, the way you hear it, and not the way you're actually saying it. Sort of like, you know when you have headphones on, and you've got people, you're speaking to someone, but you're actually shouting. But, yeah, I'm hoping I'm not shouting too loud, and I'm hoping the audio levels are okay. I know that while I've been recording, they're at about halfway to maximum decibels, which is like ridiculously loud, which is okay. And the actual gameplay audio is lowered, so it's not too bad. But yeah, I think I'm practically done for this episode. Let's go here. Rainbow Cliffs. Now, we will do the surprise at the end of this episode, which is the fact we need one. Okay, okay. So we do need to go into the other level and complete that level before we can move on to the next three, because this is obviously sort of like a starting area. We then get, we unlock a place over there or down there. I think it, the first one we unlock is down there, inside that little cavey area, where we get three more levels, and then the next three are through that fire thing, and there's another one of them boxes over there. Oh no, wrong way, sorry. Although there is one of them, whatchamacallit, what are they called? Flectrums? No, I can't remember what they're called. One more for that, and hey, you found enough golden gold, haven't you? Right, okay, what do we get? What are they? Oh, a zoomerang. Haha. So, with this, yeah, so I click Q to cycle through the things, which is easy enough. I can now zoom in and out using, that makes life a little easier. Wow, they travel far. That thing travels. Anyway, thank you ever so much for watching this episode, episode 2 of Tale of Tasmanian Tiger. I'm hoping you're enjoying the series so far. I think I'm creating them to go out every day this week, which I think is going to be quite fun. There's going to be no normal ASMR videos go out, other than the one I've just recorded. It's Sunday today. Oh, there's another one there. It's Sunday today that I'm recording this. Monday night will be one of these. Will be the first episode, as well as Tuesday night. Wednesday will be one of these, plus a video I recorded today, if I think that it's good enough. If not, it won't be there. But basically, it was just a normal eating video. But the food wasn't particularly nice, and I was quite disappointed, and I was raging. Yeah, it probably won't go out. I've exported it to my computer, so I can always just do it as a bonus, just to get it out there, sort of thing. But yeah, anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you ever so much, and bye bye.